ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the MLG AW Open. We are here in a Championship Losers Round 4 matchup. Now game 3 between Optic Nation and this opposing team, Aware. Tied up 1-1, Maven. Uplink on Biolab. What are your thoughts on this map?
My thoughts, honestly, I'm going predictions first. I said that the S&Ds and the uplinks have kind of been the swing games for people losing those hard points. I see Optic Nation taking a 2-1 lead in this one. But for me, this isn't as much like, let's say, we talk about comeback, how everyone has all these designated shots for these jumpers.
Yeah.
You know, we saw Moch hitting like 6 in a row yesterday for Justice. This one's a little bit about more control, trying to get control of the other team spawning, a little bit of a rally gun.
Yeah, if you're a viewer out there and have never played uplink before, just know that you can pass this satellite drone extremely far. Now, accuracy sitting in one of the best pass spots here. You get on top of that roof, wait for one of your players to get in position, and then just basically throw it across the map.
Yeah, you basically just have to get somebody. You know, you kind of want a player on top of that roof and CTF as well when you're on the offensive side of things. Same applies to uplink, as he should be able to get throw through one here as long as he lines it up.
Nice shot.
And there it is. Great shot from accuracy, able to put through that one pointer. Aware going to be the first team on the scoreboard.
Yeah, something I want to point out there is Proofy was actually had his back turned to the ball. I think Proofy was afraid that he was going to throw it to someone on top of his roof, so he was watching that top yellow roof, but unfortunately it did not pay off there for him as accuracy just went up and said, you know what, I'll just throw it in. Now we're going to see Sender. Can he throw this one in? Just short. That's going to bounce off the map. He just completely failed that one.
Well, if they end up losing by one, that was a gimme.
Yeah.
I mean, he pretty much had that one lined up there. Sender, though, not able to punch it through. We'll see here as he is going to get stunned, trying to get shots on this player out here in snow. But the drone is going to be in the hands of accuracy. We already saw him poke one through. Let's see if he can make some magic happen again. And he might get a similar angle. He needs a little help from his teammates. At least some distractions here, and he should be able to get a shot off.
Yeah, he's just trying to stay alive at this very moment now, rotating back towards his base. He's going to get up top here on top of the blue building. Now rotating back as stuns are starting to fly in. Optic Nation getting aggressive towards him. He's still waiting up top, but look on the minimap, Maven. No one even near being in position to pass the ball to or satellite drone to.
Yep.
So
well, did you say it's safe to say that the Sentinel side is the favorite side in this?
I would agree because you could easily just
because of the setup
pass the
ball about.
Across.
Yep.
Now, what's interesting is that coming up here in the next few seconds, we're going to see this yellow building start dropping in.
That's four down.
There you see the helicopter. Nice dunk there by Happy. 3-0 now, but there you saw that beautiful pass there from the Aware Gaming squad. But now, Maven, this is that building that comes in. How much does this building drastically change this game mode?
Well, it affects, you know, your passing angles to a degree just because it's right in between what we were just talking about.
Yeah.
You don't have that clear line of sight through snow to try and get the top building, but they do still have the 3-0 advantage. Very, very good start as we're 3 minutes into this one. But, I mean, it's hard to say it doesn't affect it. It really just it cuts off angles for the team trying to score on that side.
Yeah, and as you can see now, Embo's finally getting the ball in Optic Nation's possession. As of right now, though, it has been all Aware at the start of this game. Lawless went absolutely dominant in game one at 45 and 35. Now 14 and 6 here in game two. He is playing on fire in the respawns.
The difference,
right now.
I mean, it makes it a little bit harder for that long pass to top building, try and get the dunk. But if you can get into that newly acquired building with these new dynamic sets, it sets up for some pretty easy shots.
Yeah. Well, now we see that Happy finally got taken out there. Ball is sitting at 15 and 6. He has a satellite drone in hand. He's going to rotate here, but now look in the minimap. I'm going to highlight the player you want to watch. It's going to be Happy. Trying to get in position. Can he beat the Embos in the gunfight? No, he can't. Massive gunfight win there for Optic Nation.
Yeah, I love this because you really need to think about it's not always the guy with the drone that's the most important. You got to
nice
think of who's he trying to set up. You know, where can I intercept this pass? Where can I cut down a player that's going to try and get in that power position to go through for the dunk? And that's why I think, you know, so many complaints, right, about uplink early on.
Oh, yeah.
How many tweets have you seen this weekend from fans, whether it's on Reddit or on tweets or from players, talking about that the fact that they enjoy uplink more than CTF and they're really starting to fall in love with this game type?
Oh, yeah. I think it's a fantastic viewing experience. I think players are finally starting to learn how to play it. I think we're seeing less of the ridiculously drastic 17-1 scores of just one team throwing it across the map over and over. Now, do people think passing still needs to be fixed?
I agree.
Is that,
there
is
needs
that
be
definitely a little strong?
Yeah, yeah.
But it's not like week one where people were just camping the opposing team's base, killing everything, and then just throwing it in over and over. We're seeing way more strategy. Accuracy now running it. Can he score this one? Just short yet again.
Oh, but it stays there. And they're spawning out. His team's got him covered. He's got an easy dunk here.
There
and that's the nice thing. If you get control of that base, you know, I think he was the one that caused base. I don't think there was anyone really in that close other than him. Able to get them spawned out. A couple players were getting a little over aggressive there on the opposition. Allowed for an easy dunk and a 5-0 lead here with just a few seconds remaining.
5-0 in favor of Aware. And at the end of side one, Maven, every single player on this Optic Nation squad is negative, that is definitely the reason why they are
starting. Yeah, it's a big part of it. And like, you just can't give up your base. Like,
yeah.
There was no one at home there. Everyone was mid-map or coming off a spawn. And I mean, is a lot of that due to the fact that Aware is outslaying them? Absolutely. But at the same time, you got to have somebody there. You can't miss a throw like that, trot 40 yards, pick it up, and then get a dunk through without a bullet coming in.
Yeah, he, I think, took 15 seconds to score that last one. Flawless. Started game one, 19-9, but he is one-upping himself right now at 21-9. Zero uplinks, but he doesn't need to when he's killing everything in sight. Sender also joining him, like we saw in game one. Both of these players definitely knowing how to beat Optic Nation here in the respawn game modes.
Yeah, it's been all Aware right now. We'll see if they can keep this up. And you know, I thought this would be the one where Optic Nation could get back into it. But I do think, you know, we talked about the fact, I think that was the better side that Aware had. The comeback is not impossible, but they've got to worry more about, you know, I've heard, I think it was kind of like Aches and Sensor. I was listening to the FaZe play this game type, and they talk so much about the fact that you just need to slay first. Get control, then worry about the drone. You don't need to be focusing on scoring this thing the entire time. You got to get map control first.
Yeah, definitely teams love to play for the control of the area, specifically by the satellite drone spawn. You want to make sure that if a team plays the ball or if no one's in possession, you can easily grab that and then manipulate which path you guys go down to score. Now we're seeing as both teams just trading kills back and forth. No one really getting an advantage here on side number two.
I mean, right now I think it's just about 20 kill advantage.
Oh, it's absolutely ridiculous. 14 of it coming from Lawless.
Yeah, and that's nuts, especially with this much time left on the clock. We have just under four to play here inside two. Cinder going to get cut down. Karma picks up two. TP1, a few down right now for
Karma.
Aware. Some big gunfights. Karma's going huge right now, and this is what this team needs. They're moving forward. They should be able to get one or two points. You see the spawn coming out. They need to get a couple kills here, and this should be a two-pointer.
Here we go.
Yeah.
Great cover.
Oh, you need to get him up top there.
Squad. Will TP be able to score this?
There comes a stun.
Yes,
did he
cut
him short? He did get it through. I couldn't even see for a second.
Oh, I know. He was so stunned.
But fantastic stuff there. That's like, that's almost like what are you, in the NBA? A hard foul coming in as you're trying to dunk it through.
Oh, exactly. A flagrant right there coming in from the opposing team. But something I want to point out here, Maven, is the use of stuns here in uplink. We haven't seen stuns be so popular in a Call of Duty game up to this point. As typically, you can just run them, but here, you can't have nades and stuns. They're just rocking the typical stun grenade setup, too, basically, on every single player because they are so strong.
And you talked about players learning to play. They weren't used that much at the beginning.
Nope.
And that's why you saw these huge scores, because you'd be able to rally. Whereas now, if you know the ball's going to reset, you hit that spawn with a couple of stuns, no one's going to be getting that ball and getting out right away. You've seen how effective stuns are in this game.
Oh, they're absolutely dominant. I think, though, we're going to be seeing more utilization of the EMP grenades the later we get into this game, and later in the life cycle. But now we see Proofy here, stuck on top of this top blue building. Optic Nation knowing that they only have 2.5 minutes left here to score, failing on that throw, trying to get it into purple room. Proofy gets taken out.
Oh, he got lucky. I think it was Karma that saved what possibly could have ended up being a little bit of a rally there towards their home base. But as it stands now,
Karma. Oh, wow. Happy.
That would have been disgusting.
Yeah, Karma has such nice movement in this game. You saw there, he just scaled up that wall, got on top of the blue roof, unfortunately was taken out due to a stun grenade. Now we're going to hop on board here with Accuracy. Not doing much this game, but it's because Sender and Lawless are both at 29 kills. Absolutely ridiculous slang flower here.
And they don't need to, it's still a two possession game, so they don't need to get overly aggressive if you are Aware. They really can just slay right now for the most part. That's what you're seeing them do. If they get a one pointer or a two pointer, comes through, makes this a one possession game, that's going to be huge. They just need to get any kind of points on the board right now if you're Optic Nation. Just bring this within one score, because as we get down here to the final 90 seconds, they're going to start to panic. I mean, you get a little anxious when there's this little time left and you've got a two score game.
Because I'm Happy is now 23-15 on a 7 streak. Maven, I know you like
seven
that song
streak.
Right now.
You know, your voice is like that of an angel.
Hey, thank you so much. Maven, it does mean a lot. People do tell me that I do sound like a beautiful person, but not as beautiful as you. I don't even know what I'm getting at, guys. But
nice shots
if
coming
there
in there.
One thing I know is Happy is going off.
Oh, yeah, he's crushing. And there comes another one.
Gosh.
Now the 9 streak continues.
Just shooting everything.
Blowing up everything. This is target practice for Happy. And there's one down to his left. We see this player. Can he win another gunfight? 10 streak. He's crushing. Two more outside. Let's see if he can keep it going, Courage.
Stop this right now, Happy. You're going too ham. We need to have this game be close. Now we're going to see here as he continues putting shots out of these players. Can he pick it up? Yes, he does. 11 streak, Maven. This is absolutely incredible from this player.
Yeah, this is going to make it tough to mount a comeback when you're just getting toasted. Are they not trying to shoot at him right now? Happy on a 12 streak, 28-15. We've been talking so much about Lawless and Cinder. In a matter of 45 seconds, Happy is just taking complete control.
Prior, oh my God. Prior to this life, he was 16 and 15, finally taken out now. 29 and 16, look at these stats. 34 and 23, 31 and 23, 29 and 16, and accuracy struggling there, but it's because his teammates are taking all the kills. Only 10 seconds remaining. Maven, game three is gonna go to Aware.
Yeah, and take a look at the numbers. You know, sometimes you get a little flack for talking too much about slang, but when you look at those numbers, that came down to slang.
Yeah. It completely.
I want to see the total numbers here, just see what the actual advantage.
I just counted up.
What was it?
Aware was positive 24. That's absolutely dominant. I don't think I've ever seen a team win a respawn game mode going negative 24 as a squad.
Oh, it's much more than – it's got to be more than 24 because 11
– oh, accuracy is negative 10. That's a big difference.
Oh, so when, yeah. I just looked at the top players. I'm like, we're over 30 here.
Oh, no.
Yeah, that makes
accuracy,
more sense, you know?
Not able to pick up any kills there as the rest of his team is going absolutely huge. I was seeing people saying, you know, the caster's got to be more honest with some of the players here. Optic Nation.
Shoot your guns better.
Yeah, needs to step their game up because right now they're getting dominated in the respawn
and
game mode.
You know, that was, you saw Proofy stepping up in game number two. He got the slaying going a little bit in this game at 25 and 28. Karma, I said those are the two that have to slay. They improved at least over the hard point, but TP and Bose right there, 17 and 27, 19 and 30 with that 0.63 ratio for both is just not going to get it done. Now, the next game type is going to be capture the flag on Ascend. This is one I actually haven't had the pleasure of viewing this weekend. I haven't seen a lot of Ascend action. So stay tuned. Quick commercial break. Courage and I'll be here. MLG.TV. Todd Robb.